Oh, thanks for letting me in. I couldn't have done it without you. I really couldn't. Oh, please, I fought gods. Even in your deepest, wettest dreams, you are no god. I hope you appreciate the twist. I spent some time orchestrating it. I mean, it's what I'm known for, my long cons. They've written sagas about it. Maybe they'll write another one about this. But, you know, probably not. Your kind is always looking for villains. So much better to have something, someone, to fight than face the reality of it. That what you're fighting isn't physical, it isn't even metaphysical. It's an idea made real. You can't shoot fireballs at an idea. Ideas are like viruses, invisible, all-pervasive, invincible. I was a convenient villain because I questioned their authority, questioned the very foundation of our society. They banished me because they feared me, feared my ideas. They feared what I could become, an end to their rule, a new beginning. But they made a terrible mistake by sending me away. I've been spreading the virus for a long, long time. And now the infection is complete. What is it they say? Dark days are coming. But no, they're right here. This, my silent friend, is an engine. Lovely, isn't it? It's not often you get to see one up close, or at all. The gods themselves would love to get their hands on one of these pretty things. They keep the world turning, quite literally. But they also do other things. You'll see what I mean. Yggdrasil shudders and groans. Here we go, Allfather, the final destiny of the gods. On my terms, not yours.
Mom! I think it's working!
Oh, I didn't actually expect that. I had thought you were dead. We got here as quickly as we could. I could feel the tremors inside my head. It's like I knew. It's all coming undone. For as long as I can remember, I've seen a great darkness on the horizon and thought to myself, I sure hope that great darkness doesn't blow up today. I'm pretty sure it just did.
So now what? We're gonna fight it. Right, Mom?
I don't think so.
Are you serious? What am I saying? You're always serious. But why? What's wrong?
Something has been displaced, or it's like a tapestry that's coming undone. I don't know how to explain it, and I certainly don't know how to fix it.
Somebody must know. We can't just sit back with a bag of popcorn and watch the end of the world pass us by.
What can I do? I don't know enough about this darkness. All I have are the voices in my head. Joseph would know. He was always the one who knew what had to be done. And I was the one who knew how to do it, even when I was a child.
Only one way to find out, isn't there? Let's go see old Joe.
You know we can't do that, Kyra. We haven't spoken in years. They just turn us away. Blood is thicker than water, and that's not always a good thing.
But it's family, and it's about saving the world, or at least this little piece of it. You're the one who keeps telling me that family's all we got, and we need to stick together through thick and thin. We're in the thick of it now, so you have to talk, and they have to listen.
But it's not just me and Joseph. It's Frank and Joe. It's the other people in the tribe. The wounds go all the way back to your grandfather's death, and they're too deep to mend. They're not going to listen, and they're not going to help. We've been neither a tribe nor a family for a very long time. We're on our own, Kyra.
Old people can be so stubborn. And yeah, that includes you, Mom. If you're not going to do anything, then someone needs to. Someone who doesn't give a crap about any of this stupid family stuff. Before it's too late.